Here in this video, we'll look at a cross section of the hedge, where I'll explain why this kind of hedges are extremely important in a forest farm situation. Now, we are going close to the hedge. The front row of this portion has the Alpinia galanga. You can show the flowers, nice. Very pretty flowers, and it's a herb. It's an income fetching herb. And then when you go one step forward, there's calamus here. This is a thorny herb, medicinal herb of Ayurveda, which is still about 4 years old and just now peeping out of the hedge. This one, you can see the thorns. I can see so low portion, okay. This is a calamus stem, the thorns. These are horrible thorns, by the way. And then, beyond that is the Arthoda. Now, let's sit down here. See, at the ground level inside the hedge, all these leaves have fallen. This is the mulch creation is happening. And then this is a good place. No one disturbs this section. So, ants can have an undisturbed place for their nest. And I raised a little bit that side so that the water doesn't flow out. It traps the water. Provides a permanent home for ants and all kind of insects, and it generates mulch, a lot of mulch, because these shrubs put out their own dry leaves, and blocks the wind, improves the groundwater situation by improving percolation, and improves the biodiversity. See how much space is created. This I call as the first floor. That's the ground floor here, down there, here. This is the first floor. And then all over there will be spiders and all kind of little birds can make their nests here. And then we come up, second floor, little higher. And then here the calamus is peeping out. And then we come to the fourth floor, where the top of the, this section we can trim periodically, so that the height is maintained, like that. And then, this is the Erythrina indica. It's a nice hedge tree also. Oh, I'm getting bitten by my hand. Okay, now go forward, like that. Now this Arthoda vasa is an excellent hedge where watering cannot be done. It's quite hardy, and it provides little white flowers for the nectar sucking birds in the peak of the summer. One more plant. Now go forward. So this is the end of the hedge. The whole hedge is about 4 feet wide. At the bottom some grasses also there. These also stop the rainwater from flowing.
You can see a stark difference from the outside and the inside.